we've just recorded a new album for the first one for 10 years. We came out of the studio literally the week before we came over to South Africa, and we've just started. We haven't quite finished recording our first new album for 10 years.
We've actually just done a new thing this year for the first time in 10 years, so it's kind of that's why I'm a bit hazy about how we're supposed to do it. This time around, we just get together and we just play stuff in the studio, and whatever sounds good, that's what we'll do. So it's like, and then I write the words. So I kind of have an idea of what I want to sing about when we record, and then I kind of turn it into a song.
Yeah. And then you have a new album.
Yes, so we'll also be playing new songs as well later in the year. So.
First one in 11 years, is that right?
10, I think. 10.
What took so long? What happened?
Life intervened.
So this one, is this one special in any way?
This will be the best thing we've ever done, by a long way.
Backstage at Madison Square Garden a few years ago, and this is going back right when you had those three shows in a row, sold out shows.
Yeah.
Robert had said to me that I love this lineup so much. I love the way we sound. We are going straight into the studio right after the tour. We're going to make that record. It's going to come straight out. And it's several years later.
I was
so
say,
what
how that,
happened?
How that work?
Haven't you learned anything?
Well, he was so excited.
You should never believe anything Robert says. It's taken me 30 years to get to that stage. But I'm like, yeah, right, okay, yeah.
Well, now you have 19 songs. They're not mixed.
This record, which I personally think will be the last Cure record. You know, I know it's been said a million times before, but at this stage in our lives, it's epic. I can say that about it. I mean, you know, playing it and sitting there and listening back to it, everybody's like, jaws were dropping. Some of the, you know, and we're thinking about playing it live whenever we get to do that, wherever it gets finished. This new record is epic. I said to Robert a couple of years ago, or maybe 3 years ago, we were sitting somewhere, I can't remember what it was, and I said, we have to make one more record, and it has to be the saddest record that's ever been made. And the most, you know, dramatic. And I think it will be.
Wow.
Don't hold me to that. You know, well, probably end up a load of pop songs on there, but at the moment, it's massive and epic.
We're looking forward to the new album, which is coming out when again? When's that new album coming?
Who knows?
Halloween.
Meanwhile,
it's Halloween,
people,
yes. Laurie
should check out. Laurie knows. Okay.
So I'm juggling my time with doing that and also trying to finish a new album. The closer I get to finishing something new, the more excited I get about it, and the more I want other people to be excited by it.
Do we have some sort of release date? I mean, maybe the new record's going to come out around Christmas or sooner.
It will be out for Christmas, or I don't know what I'll do. Some kind of, like, I won't even say. So, yeah, I
mean, what's the status of the record now? Are you in final mixes, or where are you at?
I need to. It's at a point where I need to sing some of them, because there are a couple of really long songs. There's a couple of like 10-minute songs, and without some kind of vocal performance and structure. So it's a kind of halfway house, like I was saying before, I never sing. This time I'm going to have to sing a couple of the songs, because otherwise I can't utilize, particularly something like, we've got Reeves in the band, Reeves Gabrels, and I want to use him, you know, in a way that maybe hasn't been used so much. He's such a fantastic guitarist and so versatile. I mean, he has a sound, but he's also incredibly adaptable, as he's proven through the years that he's been playing with us. And I want to use that, you know, what he's learned, I suppose, what I think he's learned about playing in The Cure. And I think the best way to do it, because he plays around, because he's played Bowie in particular, he plays around the vocalist, and he's brilliant at doing it. And so in order to get the best out of him, I really need to be the vocalist. So I need to put some vocals on some of the songs to allow him to really perform. You know, the drums, bass, the six-string basses, all that kind of stuff, a lot of the keys. The basic songs are there. I need to put some vocals on, which is what I'm supposed to be doing tonight.
You mentioned these, you know, 10-minute songs in length. I mean, those were Roger yesterday was using. He said, "Epic, massive." Yeah. those were the kind of words that he was using. Is that a reasonable way to characterize these songs?
Yes, my only dilemma at the moment is getting a running order that works. I've gone through so many different running orders. My favorite running order is so utterly bereft of hope. It's so morose. I played it to a couple of people whose opinions I value, and they just look at me and think, you know, it's so dismal in a really good way. But it's just relentless, and it's like kind of 40. My favourite under is about 47 minutes of just relentless kind of doom and gloom. I realise that, you know, probably to make it slightly more interesting, in the same way that the pornography had Strange Day on it and Disintegration Scott, Fascination Street and
yep.
Lullaby, it manages to, you know, the best albums manage to have a sound and a character and create an atmosphere and a mood, but you're allowed to play within that, and that's just what I'm struggling a little bit with. So I think we're going to have to go back in and do another song. We didn't do one of the demos that I'd written because I thought it wouldn't work, and I actually think the album needs just something ever so slightly off kilter to make the rest of the songs work a bit better. So it's weird, we haven't done it for 10 years. I've fallen out of practice of, you know,
how you do this,
how to put it together. Yeah. So the individual songs, fantastic, but now I'm faced with, like, how do I turn this into something which is a piece? Well, if I'm honest, I think we've already recorded two albums worth of stuff. So, I mean, it's either going to be a double album or there's already two albums made if I can get the words and the singing done. I'm
There'll
not
really
good with deadlines, you may have noticed. It's really, really slow and doomy, the new album. And we just kind of did it in rehearsal for on the first day, and everyone was looking at each other. I knew what they were thinking, but no one wanted to say it. It's like, there was no way we could, it just wouldn't fit. Later in the year, we're going to be playing our own shows, and we will be playing new album songs in that show.
Have you got an idea when that's coming out?
Well, I have to finish singing about 4 or 5 songs left, and it has to get mixed. So I'm still aiming for it to be kind of like an autumn release, because I think it will be the right time of year, kind of like early November, mid-November, that kind of, when it's got really, really miserable and people are, you know, prepared to sit down and listen to it.
You are working on your new album that is hopefully coming out soon.
Yeah, I was it's most of it's done. It's just my singing that isn't done. It's just the vocals that need doing. It's like it's always the same. It just takes me a lot longer to because I'm very aware that we haven't made an album for more than 10 years, I really need to get the vocals right. Just the words, not even the singing. Just I need to, because I think it may, you know, I always think that it will be the last Cure album, but I want this to be so good, you know.
And it won't be your last.
But we do you hope. Know something I don't? But when we've got the new album out next year, we will come and play Kyoto and Osaka and Tokyo. I think it's the end of a period of 10 years since the last album, because we're about to bring out a new one.
And in terms of 2020, will it be one album, two albums, three albums?
You'd like it to get one the way I'm working, but yeah, I'd still like to do it. There's only really two. The third thing is just me. It's just noise. It literally is just like an hour of noise. It's not really an album. I wouldn't call it an album. But yeah, the first one will definitely be out. I mean, we're wrapping it up now, so it's going to be mixed. So, you know. But until it's out, no one's going to believe me. So I look forward to it coming out more than anybody else, trust me. So.
But you guarantee you're on camera, we will have an album this year.
It's what?
We will have an album this year.
No, I'm too old to commit to idiot things like that. Wait and see.
I read an article that said there might be three albums. What is going on? What are you, yeah, where are you at?
I said that slightly tongue-in-cheek. I did one of my very few interviews last year. Because I did this thing at home where I did an hour of noise. It's not really music, it's just like an hour of noise. I was doing loops. I bought loads of different pedals and I plugged everything in, and I filmed myself on a virtual reality camera to see what it would be like, and I set loops going and I walked around this big room just playing stuff, and that was like one of the three albums. It's no way an album. It's me being funny. It's just noise. If it was anyone, you know, I mean, I'm not so stupid as to think like I can make noise and it's art. But it's brilliant fun, you know. It's like a really good thing to do. The Cure album is I have to sing it. It's all that's left to do. It's done. I just need to sing it, and I've sung about half of it. It's like 13 songs, and I've sung six of them. I just can't get some of them right, and I think after all this time, I'm not just going to be pushed. I know everyone's waiting. No one's waiting for it more than I am, honestly. But last year, we've done all this stuff, really from February right through to kind of September. We were working, and when I had time, when we did come home, you know, for a few days, the last thing I want to do is kind of get in front of a microphone and start singing. So I've only really picked it back up again in December. So it'll get done, and when it gets done, it will be the best thing we've ever done. I mean, that, I have no doubt. It is absolutely brilliant, which is why I can't afford to not do the best vocals I've ever done. It's and it's not about tone or notes and stuff. It's emotion, and it's trying to capture that point where you feel something enough to communicate it, but you don't break down. Because it's how I hate myself when I do that. I do it live and I get away with it because it's just like, you know, sometimes it's too much for me and I kind of, oh. But this is going to be listened to over and over and over, hopefully, into the future. And I just want it to be perfect. And it's really hard for me to get that right moment. But I will get it, you know.
So the song, so it's written, but it's just you just got to lay down the vocal track in one you're happy with.
Everyone's done. And then I think there's about three solos, which always get done, but like that I'm going to play, that get done after the vocal so I can respond to what I've sung. But it's just, you know, I've set a studio up at home, a little studio, with the gear that I've been using to record it, so that I'm not kind of worrying about going to a studio and doing it, because I think maybe that's part of the problem. That I keep thinking of that, and some of the songs are incredibly sad. They mean an awful lot to me, and I think that I'm struggling performing them in front of people. Yeah. So I'm thinking maybe I should just do you know, on my own in a small room, it might work. But it will get done. It will definitely get done.
And sound-wise, is it entering new territory for the band or classic Cure?
I think it's an extreme. It really is an extreme version of. It is relentlessly sad. Mm. I have to say, like, we've never done anything remotely as dismal.
Really?
No. I mean, people think Disintegration and Pornography are like. Pornography was kind of angry and you know, and Disintegration, but had its lighter moments. This has no light moments. I mean, I've been kind of like cajoled into putting it, let's have a bit of light relief, but it doesn't work. The whole thing's just, it's just over an hour, and it's hard work in one way, but for me personally, hopefully people will respond to it in the way that I respond to it, which is like in a cathartic way. I know people use that word a lot, but. There is something. It's. I'm trying to create something that starts somewhere and ends somewhere, and I'm trying to like take you on this sort of like take you through this story that I'm trying to. Kind of, it's tricky talking about something when no one's heard it, but I think when people hear it, they'll understand what I've been talking about, and I honestly think it's the best thing that we've done.
Our whole idea for this year was really finishing off the album that we started last year, me finishing off a solo album, and also finishing digitizing like decades of stuff that we've got, the videos and stuff, in order to make this film with Tim Pope about the history of the band. So it's actually benefited me because there have been no other distractions. So I've actually got a lot of what I wanted to do done.
Robert, good luck with finishing off the records. And I'm not going to press you for release dates. I realise that's, I mean, never going to happen.
Yeah, I'll just come up with an imaginary date.
Yeah.
Pick one.
I have to ask the Cure stuff. Like, what's the like state of the union for Cure as it relates to like new albums? Or, you know, a lot of my guys that I talk to, they do have summer festivals booked. They're not really saying it yet, but it looks like we're going to be moving forward with big concerts in the summertime. Reeves, what are the song titles on the new Cure album, and when is it coming out?
All of them, numbers included, please.
We first won't line of be. Lyrics. You won't see us this summer.
Okay.
Out. You're saying we won't see you live in
2021.
Okay.
In the summer of 2021. After that, I'm not sure. We have recorded enough material for 2 records.
Awesome.
But the problem with that is, in order to judge what songs go with which songs, you need to bring them to completion. Which is what is making it take longer, and COVID obviously is making it take longer. You know, there's plans to maybe do something in the fall, and then there's plans to do something all next year. You know, in 2022, this was going to be an off year, or 2020 was going to be.
You know, I know that there's been a lot of talk, Robert, about this long-awaited new album, and last year you popped your head up as well and talked about some solo work, even though you mentioned before you've always been against it. And I just wonder what the lay of the land is with Cure right now. I'm sure churches won't mind me asking. I'll get done in if I don't ask the question.
Probably in about 6 weeks' time I'll be able to say when everything's coming out and what we're doing next year and everything. So it's on that point where I'm finishing up stuff. The reason I was doing something on my own was for exactly the same reason I was doing collaborators. I've always wanted to do an hour's worth of noise, and I didn't want it like the Cure. You wait 10 years and then we bring out an album that's just like noise. It was like, no. You know, I mean, apart from that was me doing the rest of the band. That no was like a band no. So I've been just having fun with that, really. And so that we were doing 2 albums. One of them is very, very doom and gloom, and the other one isn't. And they're both very close to being. I just have to decide who's going to mix them. That's really all I've got left to do. So, yeah.
And the last time we had you here, we talked about a potential 2 or 3 albums on the horizon.
Did we?
They were in the works. We didn't know what was happening. We understand there's at least one that's nearly ready to go.
Yeah, I split the album. That, like, so I've been working on 2 Cure albums. And one of them's finished. But unfortunately, it's the second one that's finished. So the first one is... I've got to do 4 vocals. So it's 10 songs on each album. But we're mixing next month, 1st of April. Yeah. We start mixing. So I've got 3 weeks left to finish, you know. Yeah, it's yeah. I mean, it'll. I've got. I know what it's called.
Oh yeah, go on.
I'll tell you what it's called.
Yeah,
it's called Songs of a Lost World.
Oh nice. Yeah. Okay. Amazing.
And it's got artwork and it's got a running order, so it's like it's almost done.
It's and
like,
it's coming this year.
It will be out in. I mean, the way they're so slow because of vinyl and stuff, but it might come out as early as like September probably. I
yeah.
Think. I'd rather it just came out. I can't stand the anticipation for much. It's killing me.
I mean, you previously said that you had an album of pop songs and an album of unlistenable noise.
Yeah.
Which category does that fall into?
Well, the first Cure album is relentlessly doom and gloom.
Yeah.
I have to say, it is the doomiest thing that we've ever done. The second one is upbeat, and my one won't be out till next year. But that's I have to keep revisiting it because it's a thing that I've wanted to do for so many years that when I did, I realised I've got one shot of doing it. So I've now started to add real instruments, like acoustic instruments. Whereas this time, 2 years ago, was it 2 years ago?
Yeah.
It was literally just feedback.
Yeah.
But I've kind of grown a bit disenchanted with it. I've listened to it like 3 times. I think it's rubbish. So, yeah, I'm not so worried about that. But the Cure album is just, we're about to mix it. So that's the deadline. So
yeah.
Artwork, title, mixing, so it will be real very soon.
And you previously said it will be out by the tour. What else can we expect from the tour?
Well, we're supposed to be, and we will be releasing a new album before long. But I'm fed up with saying it. So, it will, but we're going to start playing again in October. That is our first show. We played from October through to Christmas, and a new album will be out before then. That's kind of it in a nutshell.
And tell me about the new album as well, because it's been a lot of work for the band, by all accounts.
Yes, it's the name of it is Songs of a Lost World, and Robert is mixing it as we speak.
Right, okay. Can you tell us anything more? I know you've been quite tight-lipped about it. Does it touch on things like the pandemic?
Yes, possibly. Okay. I'm not quite sure, really, to be honest. I mean, musically, it does. It's I think they're more kind of slower songs. I mean, lyrically, I'm not so sure.